Harsha Walia. I'm the Executive Director at the BC Civil Liberties Association. The BC Civil Liberties Association is Canada's oldest and most effective civil liberties and human rights organization. We were founded in 1962, and over the past several decades have been at the forefront of championing civil liberties and human rights in Canada, ensuring that those rights are protected and expanded. In the past few years, some of our most significant successes have been championing medically assisted death, death with dignity. We've been at the forefront of striking down cruel and indefinite solitary confinement and ensuring the rights of migrants and refugees. We've also been heavily involved in all areas of law enforcement accountability, looking at the disproportionate racialized impact of arbitrary police stops at the municipal level in Vancouver on Black and Indigenous communities, looking at the over-policing of racialized communities. And in terms of my background, I'm very new as an executive director to the BCCLA. I've had the pleasure of working alongside the BCCLA on a range of past campaigns, particularly with respect to law enforcement accountability and Canada Border Services accountability and other similar work for very many years, 10 or 15 years. And it's an honor to be leading this organization and to continue to serve the mandate of the organization. For the BCCLA, free expression and particularly freedom of the press within that is a significant priority. Most recently, some of the work that we've done has been speaking out and advocating against the exclusion zones that media were experiencing in Wet'suwet'en territory in their attempts to report on what was happening in Wet'suwet'en territories with regards to the injunction and the Coastal GasLink injunction and the conflict and assertion of land rights that was happening in northern BC. And so we took up this matter in a range of different ways, including as part of a complaint that we filed to the CRCC, the Civilian Review Complaints Commission of the RCMP. We were pleased that the CRCC responded in general terms that was in fact unlawful, that it is unreasonable, as the courts have upheld, for media exclusion zones and media restrictions cannot stand. And so that's some of the most recent work that we've done to ensure freedom of the press, to ensure that journalists are able to do their jobs, and that, as we know, as the Supreme Court of Canada has said, that freedom of the press is vital for a free and democratic society. Our team is a small and mighty team. We are so incredibly driven and passionate about the civil liberties and human rights in Canada. We have hundreds of pro bono lawyers who volunteer their time to fight our cases and to take these cases forward. And I think the fundamental thing that drives all of us in various aspects of our work, whether it's staff or volunteers, is knowing that we have to fight every step of the way to ensure that civil liberties are protected and expanded. This is not something that we can take for granted, that rights don't just exist on paper. In order for them to be substantive and purposeful, we have to be engaged, we have to be vigilant, and especially we have to ensure that no one is left behind. So anytime that we see vulnerable communities, Indigenous communities, racialized communities, migrants, refugees, homeless communities, prisoners, sex workers, et cetera, who are being left behind in government policy, who are being disproportionately impacted by government actions, we are completely committed and driven to ensure that no one is left behind. We're committed to an ethic of solidarity, to an ethic of justice, and really the fundamental belief that civil liberties and human rights are to be enjoyed by everybody. You know, particularly when we look at some of the core work of the BCCLA, such as free expression, free expression, if we look at its evolution and its history, that is something that we have inherited, particularly from labor leaders. Labor leaders who fought for the right for free expression, for freedom of association, for free assembly. These are connections and these are legacies that our work is indebted to. And those are the legacies that we hold true in terms of furthering civil liberties and human rights. And again, some of the fundamental rights when it comes to free expression, freedom of association, freedom of assembly, and more. These are built on the shoulders of labor leaders, of immigrant labor leaders. And that is the legacy in which we continue this work. Thank you so much to the Hillman Foundation for the recognition of the BCCLA in your inaugural Canadian Prize. It means so very much to us to be recognized in this way. And for us, we remain committed as ever to expanding and protecting civil liberties and human rights in Canada, to ensuring that our fundamental freedoms are protected and expanded, and particularly for marginalized communities. And it is so important that you join us in our work. Our work is driven by those who support us. Our mandate is driven by those who support us. And we very much count on and rely on our communities and our supporter networks and those who feel that their rights are being violated to reach out to us, to tell us what our priorities should be, to help us guide our work, and to certainly join the organization and be part of the good work that I think that we are doing.